Probably marvelled at the landscape photos of our next guest. Ken Duncan has won heaps of awards for his Australian landscape photography over more than 40 years. And we've got him in the studio to share some of his best photos as well as tips on how to take them. Please welcome him back to studio. Ken, hi. Good to see you.
Good to be here.
Oh, you're so good. What do you look for?
No, really, average photographer, great God. That's what I believe.
What do you look for in a great landscape photo?
Look, I really think landscapes are humbling yourself and just being there. Okay. Stop going there with what you think you should be shooting. Just be there and see what happens. And then all of a sudden circumstances happen.
Mm. Let's have a look at some of those incredible photos that we're talking about.
Well, this is Bolivia.
Bolivia.
And, you know, we're driving, it's a lake and it's a salt lake. We had to drive 80 kilometres across this salt lake, thank God in someone else's Toyota, because it's salt lake. Yeah. But it's just reflecting off this beautiful 6 inches of water. And it's just a magical moment. So it's not Photoshop. And that's what we got to, a cactus island. It's just like, this is surreal in the middle of nowhere. And so, you know, life's an adventure. And I just love bringing these things back to people. And what I want to try and do is bring it back as real as possible so that people can experience that moment. Because I think our world's very stressed out right now and we need to get back in connection with our land.
Do you put filters on your photos and do you touch them up?
I don't use filters. I don't like filters personally, except, you know, UV filter or something like that. But
what about the Valencia filter that's on Instagram? I like that filter. That's always a very complimentary one for most images, I think.
Look, you can have all that, but I really try to capture decisive moments in time as best as you can.
But, you know, so that's pretty much just a pure landscape.
If you saw that, that's what you'd look like.
And you don't have to go that far and wide, do you? Your next three photos we're going to have a look at are in Australia and New Zealand.
Lupins over in New Zealand. It's just so beautiful.
God. You know? I love lupins. They
Are they gorgeous, you know?
And this, of course, is
is up in the Kimberleys. This is King George. Now, when you see these big, now, these files are 3.2 gigs.
What does that mean?
That's huge. In other words, you can do a 7-metre print there and you'll see every detail
in it. 3,500 megabytes.
Yeah, well, you know, that's right. It's lots.
But how long does it take you to capture that image? How many other images have you had to take to get the perfect shot?
Everyone's perfect. No. Look, it takes time. Like, I'm working on shots. I've been working on shots for years. So, to me, it's not about trying to fake it. It's to wait for that decisive moment. And often I'll go and I'll... It doesn't happen, so I think, oh, well, back again.
Do you go and sit up and wait and wait and wait till the light's just right and everything's there and then you go... Or do you go...
No, no, no.
It's digital, isn't it?
Otherwise you'll spend forever going, what am I doing?
So you take heaps of...
No, you've got to wait, I believe, for that decisive moment. I reckon great photos are gifts given to you if you'll just chill out and see what happens.
Now, we've got a photo taken in Chile. What's that one?
Oh, look, how's that? Torres del Paine. Like, that's...
Wow.
It's just like I saw that sunrise and if you blow it up, there's a little person right down there and you get a scale, you can't see, but on that right-hand spit, there's a little photographer down there. And then you just see this little person in this immense scheme. And I think bringing things like this, I love bringing it back because when you put something like that on your wall, if you're having a stressful day and you go home, you
say, look at that.
That's where I am.
Yes.
When you were taking that photo, did you shout out from the top of the hill, get out of my shot?
No. I want them in there. I want people in my shot because a lot of people don't want to have no one in the scene because they'll start to get stressed out. So it's good to have scale, humanity in it.
And not only do you take landscapes, you also take wildlife.
I love wildlife. Yeah, look, these are elephants over in Botswana. But you see, they're such a part of the scene, and it was so funny because that big guy who's sort of on
flapping
his ears, he's just seen me and he's wanting to come over and stomp on our hide, which was very interesting.
But I think you've got some giraffes as well.
This is amazing. Now, that's a real magical moment. And this
shot,
we went there and these giraffes all came in and then there was a decisive moment where you get the separation of the animals and it was just like... And, you know, for me to say, I did that, it's not. It's God. He's just turned up.
What are the little ones underneath?
Are they zebras?
They're zebras and there's four zebras. But it all just, it's like often it just unfolds before you and your job is just click.
It looks like a painting.
Yeah, I love that.
I want to get a camera because I want to take photos of sunsets and there was a beautiful orange moon and I tried to take it with the camera and it just came out black. Look, so what's a good camera get to start with.
Get a little Lumix. Depending on what size, they're really cool because they're easy to use and you can shoot raw.
Now that means... buy them at Aldi, though?
I'm not sure.
They might be expensive.
No, they're not. Yeah, well, I like that brand. And, because
that'll be good
simple.
Enough for me if
how
I get a photo.
How much are they about?
Well, they range from $500 up to a couple of $1,000s. But you know, they've got some amazing technology and they work with Leica, who's a...
What about those $15 Kodak cameras you get from 7-Eleven that throw away?
We want to show some of your other photos as well, while we're looking through those, because most of us just want to take happy snaps with our iPhones or our smartphones. So explain to us what your best tip is for taking a photo that looks a bit arty and a bit special, but on a cheaper camera or an iPhone, because $500 for a camera is a lot.
Look, photography is all about light. You know, photography is painting with light, so it's about the light. And often when I see people with iPhones, I'm watching them, I'm thinking, man, that light is so bad, you're blowing it straight away. So just try and look for the light or take the person into the light.
And generally speaking, I think you want the light behind you, don't you? So the light's shining on the thing.
So you've got some nice, even light.
So it's even, it's not dappled, so the camera doesn't get confused.
Yeah, so just look at the light. And I think light's like dancing around you, and if you just settle down, you'll start to see the light, and then you'll go, there it is, that's the moment, bang.
Do you see pink light?
Pink light?
Yeah.
Well, no, I've never seen... Well, I've seen pink light at sunset.
Yeah, because I think that's so beautiful.
Mm. Oh, it's so beautiful.
Like that.
Now, that's a magical moment. That's not Photoshop, but I've been there so many times, and this morning it just went off. I'm going...
Where's that?
I mean, where is this? I mean, that looks like a magical fairy light.
I know, but I've been there many times to get this, and this was in autumn, and this is in Fitzroy, and so it's down in Patagonia. And it's like fantasy land. It's just like, oh, my God.
Isn't it?
This is shot up in the Kimberleys. But see, light again. You see, that glint, that silver, is because the light's reflecting. You've just got to get that reflection of light. Look, it's just those little elements that can make a really good shot.
And patience.
Patience, yeah. If you don't become patient, you'll end up a patient, I think.
Well, if you're in Sydney this weekend, Ken Duncan and his colleagues have a two-day seminar on landscape photography at Balgala RSL Club. And Ken's new exhibition is called The Joys of the Journey and it opens on the 2nd of December at Arena on the Central Coast. For all the details, head to kenduncan.com/tours-events, or you can go to Ken's Facebook page.
Yay.
Thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.